and we send all of these things as channels into the world, into our homes, into our neighborhoods, to our neighbors, into our communities, our city, our state, our country, and around the world, so that everyone is touched by this beautiful, loving energy. If there's someone that you have in your mind at this time that you especially want to be reached out to, think of that person and know the prayer is answered. We continue to send this energy around the world and beyond and back to us, centering us in this place. And for all these things, we give thanks. Amen. And so mote it be. So it is. Thank you so much. And now, I'd like to introduce Steve Gaskell, Doer of Good, to read with us the daily word.
Happy Easter Sunday, April 12th, 2020. Our topic today is Easter. Our biblical reading today comes from Luke 24, verse 31. Then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he vanished from their sight. Our affirmation today is, I recognize the risen Christ in family, friends, and my spiritual community. Early in the evening on the day of resurrection, Jesus, unrecognized, joins two of his followers as they journey from Jerusalem toward the nearby village of Emmaus. Accepting an invitation to stay and share a meal, Jesus takes bread, blesses, and breaks it, then gives it to his hosts. In that moment, their eyes are opened. They recognize Jesus, and alive in their hearts, he vanishes from their sight. Later, the two explain to others how the risen Christ became a living presence to them in the fellowship of breaking bread. Easter celebrates the risen Christ, an immortal presence freed from all limitation, awaiting discovery in every person and life event. I recognize the risen Christ in shared experiences with family, friends, and my spiritual community. In our affirmation together, I recognize the risen Christ in family, friends, and my spiritual community. And so it is.
And we're so grateful for Steve. We wish he were here with us on the Zoom, but we're so grateful that he's recording the Daily Words with Ken so that we can have it from him every week, just like we are usually in real life service. And now I'd like to introduce again our Unity of Las Cruces Ministry Coordinator, Helen F. Wright, or Helen Wright, and she is going to share with us the affirmation for foundation
statement. There is only one presence and one power in the universe and in my life. God, the good omnipotence.
Thank you very much, Helen. And now I'd also like to extend Helen as our speaker for today. She's giving us a beautiful message on the renewal of the spirit within. And following that message, there will be a brief meditation also by Helen. Thank you.
So this is a recording because my internet seems a little unstable at times. Renewal of the spirit within. I'm so aware as we look around Las Cruces that spring is here. The trees bringing forth new leaves, flowers are blooming, and spring is here. And in the Northern Hemisphere, at least, it feels like a time of renewal in terms of when we look out into nature. It's spring, things are renewing themselves, plants are renewing themselves. And the Easter message really is that we too are renewing ourselves from within. I'm also aware that Christians all around the world are celebrating Easter this morning, and they've found very creative ways to do that in these current times of social distancing. So in preparing for this talk, I wanted to know what a few people were saying in terms of our new thought leaders about the meaning of Easter. We're celebrating the resurrection of Jesus Christ, and Ernest Holmes talks about it, the resurrection being rising from a belief in death. And he also goes on to say, our conclusion is not that dead men live again, but that a living man never dies. Knowing this changes everything. Everything for here, living on earth, in this physical realm on the earth plane. We're not mortals waiting to be immortal in some far off place and distant future, but we are immortal and have always been immortal. And this to me is truth. Unity co-founder Charles Fillmore in The Revealing Word wrote about Easter, Easter is the awakening and rising to spiritual consciousness of the I am in human, which has been dead in trespass and sins and buried in the tomb of materiality. And I like what New Thought Minister Dr. David Alexander of Atlanta wrote when applying what he calls the Easter moment, which is a personal Easter moment. The resurrection or Easter moment is a moment in consciousness where one realizes that the power of the eternal is yet still alive in them despite some setback. Transformation is the possible for all and any, because that moment can occur for anyone at any time. In considering the topic of renewal, I had to go to the dictionary and found many definitions. In Middle English, there's the word newen, which means to resume, revive, and renew. The Romans, which is the root word of renew, is renovare, and that also means renew or restore. Most of the definitions have a concept of an instance of resuming an activity or state after an interruption. And Google was not able to handle my request for a word of newing at a higher level, not at the same level after interruption, but at a higher level. And so I reflected and came up with these words of spiritual or spiral evolution of consciousness, awakening, rebirth, ascension. And the best definition for me really comes from 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17. So if spiritual evolution, so a renewal of the spirit and going within is going to a level of consciousness higher than previous. It is not resuming the same level after an interruption. And in the current world situation, I do not want to go back to business as usual. I affirm a new of deepened connection to spirit, our inner spiritual life within expanded, our connections with each other taken to a higher level of love, in divine love. As Charles Fillmore would say in The Revealing World, word, regeneration, a change in which abundant spiritual life, even eternal life, is incorporated into the body. The transformation that takes place through bringing all the forces of mind and body to the support of the Christ ideal. The reunification of spirit, soul, and body in spiritual oneness. And Matthew Fox talks about renewal of the body. And he talks about, and now we turn to the human wonders of our human bodies. One scientist has said that our 100 trillion cells in each of our bodies is orchestrated into a magnificent whole, they communicate with each other for the sake of the whole body. If the DNA in our body cells was uncoiled and laid end to end, it would reach to the moon and back 100,000 times. The heart weighs only 0.5 pounds and is the size of a clenched fist. But a normal heart does the daily work of equivalent of lifting a ton from the ground to the top of a 5-story building. In a lifetime, the heart beats about 4 billion times, delivering oxygen and nutrients to the cells of hungry tissues and organs in our body. Bones are alive. They grow back when they're broken. Every 7 years, the body grows the equivalent of an entirely new skeleton. Bones need to be exercised and maintained to maintain their thickness and strength. So 7 years ago, who were you? What were you doing? What were you eating? What was your work? What was your recreation? All of the bones in your body 7 years ago are now made new. They've now discovered that brain nerve cells do regenerate. So brain cells do regenerate. They need opportunities to grow and learn new things. So I'm thinking that our brain cells must be very happy. It too needs exercise, opportunities to overcome and become stronger and wiser. Considering our thoughts, in 2005, the National Science Foundation published an article summarizing research on human thoughts per day. It was found that the average person has between 12,000 and 60,000 thoughts per day. Of these thousands of thoughts, 80% were negative. And 95% were exactly the same repetitive thoughts as the day before. And that makes me think many things. For one, how do they do that type of research? And I like to question the validity of research. But I did check, and Deepak Chopra validates this. He also affirms the number of thoughts a day, and those that were negative, and those that were exactly the same repetitive thoughts. And personally, it feels like that could be true in terms of numbers, especially when I attempt meditation sometimes. So thinking of Father Thomas Keating, he is the father of centering prayer, where in meditation, the practice is simply letting go of thoughts one after the other. And he was leading personally one of his early retreats, and a nun came to him after the first practice of 20-minute centering prayer, and she was lamenting, "Oh, Father Thomas, I'm such a failure at this prayer. In 20 minutes, I've had 10,000 thoughts." "How lovely," responded Keating without missing a beat, "10,000 opportunities to return to God." Or 10,000 opportunities to think new thoughts. So I'm sure we've all had that experience in meditation where we would like to be in the silence and then the thoughts keep coming and coming and coming. But what would happen if we observe each thought and observe, is it negative? Is it positive? Is it a repetitive thought? And if it's a repetitive one or a negative one, blessing it, transforming it, and creating a new positive thought. How wonderful our practice might be. So in Romans 12, verse 2, it says, "And do not imitate this world, but be transformed by the renovation of your minds, and you shall distinguish what is good, acceptable, and perfect will of God." And that's from the Aramaic Bible in plain English, because there's two subtle changes of words from what we might be familiar with. One is the imitate, because we usually read, "Do not be conformed by this world." The second one is talking about the renovation of our minds instead of the renewal of our minds. So even a short, even a small change in word might cause us to reflect and see things in a different light. So my question would be to everyone, what have we done in the last 30 days that is the new? Physical, mental, emotional, and spiritual levels. What might we have done that is new and we've never done before in that way? On the physical, we might be aware of subtle changes in our body. According to Patricia Cota Robles, our DNA is changing. And she writes, since the birth of the new earth on December 21st, 22nd in 2012, the I am presence of every man, woman, and child on this planet has been raising the frequency of vibration of our earthly bodies to the maximum we can withstand in every 24-hour period. Day by day, this process of divine alchemy has been slowly changing the cellular structures of our physical, etheric, mental, and emotional bodies from carbon-based planetary cells into fifth-dimensional, crystalline-based solar light cells. As a Reiki practitioner, I sense energy changes in my body, and I've been sensing pulsing energy, warmth in my arms particularly, just subtle changes. And I'm wondering, is this affirming and validating this alchemy within the body? Bruce Lipton writes in The Wisdom of Yourselves, the wisdom of yourselves is a new biology, and we will profoundly change civilization and the world we live in. The new biology takes us from a belief that we are victims of our genes, that we are biomechanical machines, that life is out of our control, and takes us into another reality, a reality where our thoughts, beliefs, and mind control our genes and our behavior and our life that we experience. This biology is based on the current modern science and some new perceptions added. And in New Thought, we know this. Charles Fillmore knew this. Myrtle Fillmore knew this. Ernest Holmes knew this. We know this. On a mental level, observe if you've seen any changes in the last 30 days. I've become aware that the more I have to enter validation codes and verification codes, the better I'm getting at remembering numbers. Interesting. I've also noticed that on the emotional level that my values seem to have changed in terms of living in today's situation. And on an emotional level, I seem able to transmute lower vibrational energy more quickly. On a spiritual level, are you developing a stronger foundation of faith? How about demonstrations of spiritual truth and the qualities of the divine, like joy and peace and love and compassion? I'd like to share my own journey, my own story of my recent travels up to Wisconsin to bring back my cat Puma, my car, empty my house for sale and move back across country here to my home in Las Cruces. It was a spiritual journey. It was so deeply spiritual that I can't quite find all of the words yet to truly reflect what that experience was. I smile at the fact that the old for me was Wisconsin, and in Eau Claire is 797 feet above sea level. The new for me is Las Cruces, New Mexico, and we're at least 3,900 feet above sea level. So I've literally moved to a higher elevation. In order to facilitate this, though, I had to fly on Tuesday, St. Patrick's Day, the 17th. And on the Sunday and the Monday, I was praying, meditating, and listening for any guidance that might say that I should stay in Las Cruces and not make this trip. And there was nothing coming to that effect. So I did fly to Minneapolis. I did get to Eau Claire, Wisconsin. And then became the process of packing up a house that had way too much stuff, I do admit. And then packing that up with social distancing where I could maybe only have two or three people in the house at any given time. So I came to release three quarters of my possessions, beautiful things. that I would normally have kept under the Marie Como, Do I Love It? Yes, I do. I would normally have kept it. But like a hot air balloon trying to fly, I had to release in order to be able to make this move possible. And I had to work quickly. A friend of mine was very surprised that I was willing to release money to get this to happen. But already money was no longer becoming the primary important value. So yes, the initial cost was going to be $5,000 to get me packed up and moved to Las Cruces. And I could release this because the higher values of wanting to be back here, seeing myself back here in this new role, this new area of work, this that I've wanted all of my life, I believe, and new spiritual communities, all of the values of the love and joy and sacred service compared to money, release. I released the money, and along with two prosperity lines, I got the exact same sum back, near enough, in tax return. So that was also a demonstration of spiritual faith and prosperity, and God is my source. I kept affirming the vision of the new, and if ever I had a slight wobble, I returned to prayer, and I also asked and reached out on Facebook to ask you all to hold that vision, because I did wobble. One time, just seeing the number of boxes and the number of rooms, it seemed impossible. Once when a flight attendant I'd heard said that we might all be in complete lockdown within 48 hours of me arriving in Minneapolis. So I had a couple of wobbles, but mostly I was able to stay in love of life and joy and prayer and trust. I also felt a heightened sense of awareness, and I was praying and I was checking in, and it was almost like the intuition, I was in a constant dialogue with intuition, given an unknown situation with uncertainty and not knowing any of the new rules. I didn't know whether planes would fly. I didn't know whether I'd be driving cross country. And so it was basically, I kept praying and affirming divine order. And when everything was packed up on the Monday, I was staying in a motel, not a very nice motel. And that's when Wisconsin got its requirement to shelter in place. So I called the moving guy and checked to see if he was still willing to drive cross country, and he was. And his questions were, could I handle 23 hours straight through? And could I We drove at 75 miles an hour with a moving truck, a flatbed trailer behind, and my car. So even in that situation, I turned to prayer and affirmed God is driving this truck. So I did things I'd never done before. I could never have imagined having done before. And I did this in a different state of consciousness. And it was palpable. I was surrounded by love and light and protection that was really palpable. And later, when people congratulated me on being strong and independent and brave and courageous, I remembered it was God in me, through me, and as me that brought this through to completion. I'm also going to share about the conscious evolutionaries and evolution of consciousness. And before I do that, though, I'd like to share my New Brighton seminary experience back in 1996, when I was in the welcoming session and they going in for entering ministerial studies. And they asked us all to use collage and make an image representing what our mission statement would be. And mine, I probably can't show it completely here, but mine was this, as we do at the end of our service, arms stretched high, reaching for that higher level of consciousness and helping share and helping humanity reach that higher level of consciousness. I think of consciousness evolutionaries like Barbara Max Hubbard and Bruce Lipton, Greg Braden, Neil Donald Walsh, Sister Jenna, Matthew Fox, Patricia Cota Robles, many more, and us. We are evolutionaries of consciousness. So I'd like to share the qualities of an awakened species. And this is by Neil Donald Walsh in his Conversations with God. And this is book four, Awaken the Species. An awakened species sees the unity of all life and lives into it. An awakened species tells the truth, always. An awakened species says one thing and will do what they say. An awakened species, having seen and acknowledged what is so, will always do what works. An awakened species does not embrace a principle in its civilization that correlates with concepts that humans refer to as punishment and justice. An awakened species does not embrace a principle in its civilization that correlates with the concept that humans refer to as insufficiency. An awakened species does not embrace a principle in its civilization that correlates with the concept of what humans call ownership. An awakened species shares everything with everyone all the time. An awakened species creates a balance between technology and cosmology, between machines and nature. An awakened species would never, under any circumstances, terminate the current physical expression of another sentient being unless asked directly by that other being to do so. An awakened species would never do anything that could potentially harm or damage the physical environment that supports the members of the species when they are physicalized. An awakened species never poisons itself. An awakened species never competes. An awakened species is clear that it needs nothing. An awakened species experiences and expresses unconditional love for everyone. An awakened species has harnessed the power of metaphysics. And going back to the full list of what Sister Jenna White talked about last week, she talks about the qualities of soul consciousness and soul awareness. And these are what she says. You feel comfortable inside no matter what happens. Your heart is open and loving. You love yourself. God becomes your best friend. Your confidence and self-respect soars. Your life is meaningful. You understand the scheme of things. You attract beauty. Your third eye shows you reality. You have found what you were looking for. You become far-sighted. You understand your story. You can see the past, present, and future clearly. Your body becomes your instrument of expression. Peace is your religion, and spirituality is your nature. I'd like to share from New Thought Minister Reverend Bill Arrott. And he says the idea of conscious evolution is the eventual emergence of the universal conscious mind is already so well established that it must manifest. It doesn't take many people knowing the truth to make it manifest, because all the power of the universe will support it. All it takes is two. Technically, it takes one, but if locked up in the mind of only one person, nothing happens until he or she communicates it to someone else. In conclusion, we are all evolutionaries of consciousness, and every personal Easter moment when we awaken to something higher within us and we step out into a new and brighter light, rolling back the stone of any obstacle or darkness and leaving behind the cave of an older version of ourselves, then we reveal a new me, a new you, a new us, a new we. And the new me in me honors the new me in you. We, the people of new thought, with our spiritual practice of positive thinking, are called forth in these times as we renew our new and our spiritual strength. Our spirit within shines more brightly, and we radiate that light of truth into the world. And so it is. And as our meditation today, I would like to first read a book from the book Soul Infusions, and that's by Joy Drake from the Findhorn Foundation. And she has many beautiful passages, and one of them is talking about the new. So if you'd like to just prepare for meditation, settle yourself in your chair, feel your feet grounded, gently become aware of your breathing, maybe close your eyes as you feel comfortable. Into the new. Our invocation. We greet one another this morning by remembering there is but one life and we are living it. With every breath our souls meet, and spirit relates directly to and through us. Let it happen. Allow the contact to be made. Alliance with the highest means letting go of outdated beliefs and fancy trappings and moving courageously into the new. Into the now. Into the open. Into the unknown. Into the arms of love. Nothing less will see our planetary soul safely birthed. We take that, invite we to take that into meditation, into the silence, as we sit in the silence for a few moments, reflecting on into the new. And as we gently come forth from the silence, our blessing is we are moving surely and steadily into the fulfillment of the new. We see the light of spirit shining within ourselves, within each other, shining forth a message of love, understanding, gratitude, and joy. Let it shine. Shine out clear and radiant, becoming stronger as it links with other points of light around our planet, and the earth is truly blessed this morning, this Easter morning. And so are we all. And so it is. Namaste.
And thank you, Helen, for the talk, the message, sharing that beautiful message and beautiful meditation. Thank you, Helen, and thank you, God, for that beautiful sharing. And now we have some very special music, and you'll see some interesting video work by Barry Shaw and music with Max Contreras. Please enjoy You Raise Me Up.
Oh, yeah.
When I am down and oh my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. Raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Thank you, Barry and Max. If you're watching and when you're watching, thank you very, very much. Beautiful work. Thank you. And now we have Kay Brilliant with the Prayer for Faith.
Welcome to Unity of Las Cruces, where we know that God is good all the time. Please join me in prayer as we affirm our prayer of faith. God is my help in every need. God does my every hunger feed. God dwells within me, guides my way through every moment, night and day. I now am wise, I now am true, patient, kind, and loving too. All things I am, can do, and be through Christ, the truth that is in me. God is my health, I can't be sick. God is my strength, unfailing quick. God is my all, I know no fear, since God and love and truth are here. Amen. We have a couple of announcements. I want to remind you that while we are not physically with one another, we are always together under the light of God, that you can send your support, your checks, your gifts, your tithe to Unity of Las Cruces, P.O. Box 1143, that's Las Cruces, New Mexico, 88004. And tithing is a part of our spiritual discipline and our spiritual growth. So let's keep the abundance flowing. That's how it works. We give, that money goes to others with love. We give with love. We send it out in love. And of course, then love comes right back to us. And also, in addition, I want to remind you that you can offer a prayer request in any number of ways. Through Unity, Silent Unity, you can call with a prayer request, you can send mail, as we do when we're together and we do the little sheets of paper, we mail that directly to Silent Unity. Or you can submit an online prayer request form. And all of that information is on your email, or you might remember, this is where all of that information is, and you can do that. What I found really exciting is I have an Alexa, and now I can ask her to pray. Alexa, open positive prayer, and then you can ask for a specific prayer topic. If you don't have an Alexa, you can always find relief and solace in your own prayer, and you all know how to do that.
Divine love as me blesses and multiplies all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive, and I am grateful.
Thank you, Kay and Jane. We have a weekly tithe. You know, Unity of Las Cruces is a tithing church, and we do so every week. We send a check to someone. Actually, our secretary, treasurer, Tammy Powers, sends the check for us on behalf of all of us. So you can also donate to us through our website, which goes to PayPal, or go directly to PayPal and send it to us. And of course, when you shop at Amazon, type in smile before you type in Amazon, and that'll bring that up. And we are sending our check this, or Tammy is sending our check this week to Daily Word. So we're very grateful. We're grateful for all of you and all of the work that the Daily Word does, that we are very happy and grateful. And now we have an affirmation for Unity.
Good morning. This is Jane Ray with the affirmation for Unity. Guided by infinite love and wisdom, and with God as our source, we now behold unlimited possibilities as Unity of Las Cruces grows and prospers.
Please join us as we affirm the prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us, and the presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Kay and Virginia. you know, Virginia and Kay both born in Unity, and we're so grateful for both of them. And I would like to share that our next week's speaker is also Helen. It's Earth Day Sunday, and it's Helen and me. So you're getting a tag team from your ministry team here at Unity of Las Cruces. And we're going to be talking about every day is Earth Day. And so we have a little slide, because also what Helen is also doing is she's having a Wednesday Unity Daily Word meeting where she reads, and then you can discuss either the reading or something that's going on with you. And she's doing that on Wednesdays at 9:30. So that'll be a great Wednesday at 9:30. So get on the Zoom. You have the information in your email from us that we sent out on Friday. We send those out on Friday mornings. And I ask you all to please reach out to one another this week, as always, you know, maybe even a little more than usual. And if you need someone's phone number, let us know. Send us an email at unitylascruces@gmail.com and let us know if you need someone's number. We'll ask them first if we can give it to you. But that way you can reach out to someone you're missing seeing them. Well, let us know. We'll make sure you can get the number. Or just call them if you have their number. Send them a text. Any way you can, reach out to someone. Reach out to us. You know, you are loved, and you are making a difference. You make a difference to us. I'd like to thank you for attending this week's virtual Sunday service celebration. As you can see, we are a work in process, and we are planning to do this again next week. So keep all that meeting code and password available so you can jump on. We're actually usually on here around 8:30, but you can join us anytime you can. And I'd like to also say we're going to play the peace song here, and it's done by the Harlem Boys Choir. We're so grateful for that copyright-free YouTube video. And we'd like to ask you to stay around after the song, sing with the song if you want to. We'll be around if you want to stick around and say hi to one another. And please enjoy it. Let there be peace on earth.